Welcome back to Unnati Unleashed. I'm your host Sagarika Sharma, back with another remarkable guest by our side, Mrs. Tara Narayan. I welcome you, ma'am, and thank you so much for gracing us with your presence today.
Thank you so much.
Ma'am, as you have been a part of Unnati since the time of its inception, so can you please take us back to time and tell us how the first few years were?
Of course. So my connection started with the Siksha project of the SGBS Trust, mm-hmm. through which we were supporting students from various schools by giving them scholarship,
okay.
which we still do.
Mm-hmm.
And when we started with a very small number, and then it grew.
Mm-hmm.
But after the 10th standard, we couldn't do much for them. So that's when the trustees felt that we need to do something more. And they felt that instead of just giving them financial aid or a scholarship, we need to give them some skills.
Yes.
It's like instead of giving fish, mm-hmm. you teach them fishing.
Fishing, yeah.
So that's when Unnati came into. That's how when a few like-minded people mm-hmm. worked on it. Then, you know, they worked on the strategy, how to do the funding and stuff like that. And it started, it came into inception. So for me, it was a gradual transition from Siksha to Unnati. So when we took up this rented place, two-bedroom rented place in Indiranagar, I used to go there, you know, to help in setting up the place and so on and so forth. And then talk to volunteers who mm-hmm. came there. And also, we had manager with whom, you know, I used to interact and sometimes even help them, you know, arrange for the food for the students who came. And apart from that, you know, I was also taking few sessions for mm-hmm. the students, like the English class. And then later on, of course, even value sessions started when we were there.
Mm-hmm.
So this is how I used to spend my time, you know, at Unnati.
Yeah. So ma'am, as you mentioned about two-bedroom apartment and how you used to take your sessions there. So ma'am, could you please tell us how is it different today? Like today, Unnati has this huge facility, over 30-plus centers. So how is it different from that time?
For me, I would say it's always been a very, very fulfilling experience, mm-hmm. whether it was in that two-bedroom place or whether it's here in this huge building that we are. It's always been a pleasure interacting with the students, and over a period, of course, we also started having the trainers coming over. So the sessions that I was doing for the students had to be taught to the trainers. So earlier we were doing it under the name TOT, or the training the trainers,
mm-hmm.
and I used to do the value sessions
value
for
sessions.
Them. And now we have changed it to BAC, which has become a change maker. And yes, we also proudly call ourselves change makers, because
yeah.
it's something which gives us a lot of fulfillment. So when we are interacting with these students or the change makers, it's not a change which happens only in them.
Mm-hmm.
It's a change
yeah.
which happens in us change makers too.
True.
So a lot of learning happens during
yes,
this
ma'am.
Period. And when you talk of values, I used to be part of another organization also where I was volunteering.
Yeah.
And it's called VSET,
okay.
which is focusing on values or value-based education
mm-hmm.
at school level.
Yes,
so I felt that, you know, some of the sessions were very powerful,
mm-hmm.
and it can be adapted to our students here
okay.
in Unnati.
Mm-hmm.
So over a period, we made, modified it, tailor-made it to the needs of our students
mm-hmm.
here, and that's where I played a key role
mm-hmm.
and started actually, you know, getting involved
yes.
more. And yes, so that's how the time spent in Unnati has always been, you know, a pleasure for me.
So ma'am, as you said, you used to take value session, now also you are doing that. So ma'am, value is something which cannot be taught. So how do you then inculcate values into the youth?
Oh, it's a nice question, Sagarika. When you say, you know, we are teaching values,
mm-hmm.
I cannot agree with it, because when we are kids in school,
yes, ma'am.
We are taught values.
Mm-hmm.
when we are at home as kids, we are taught values. Yes. Parents teach us about values. Yes. But somewhere, you know, we are unable to practice them, or we don't put them, you know, into practice in our day-to-day life. Mm-hmm. Why does it happen? When you really think about it, this is something, you know, which made us think. When I was, like I said earlier, I was part of the organization called QECET.
Yes.
So we used to think about it, and then we felt that, you know, this has to be, values have to be touched and kindled.
Yeah.
It cannot be taught.
Yes.
So how do we touch and kindle these values? Mm-hmm. So that's when we felt we'll have to make these sessions very interactive.
Interactive, yeah.
So to make them interactive, what do we do? So then that's when we felt videos play a key role.
Mm-hmm.
And storytelling.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, storytelling in such a way that it's not a drab narration.
Yeah.
Make
that
it interesting.
That'll be boring.
That'll be boring. So even the stories have to be shared with the students in such a way that, again, make it an interactive session.
Interactive, yeah.
So you have drawings, you have a board where mm-hmm. you use, and make it very interactive.
Yes.
For example, I'll tell you,
yes,
when we talk of wasting food,
mm-hmm.
everybody knows we shouldn't be wasting
yeah,
food.
Yeah.
Who doesn't know? Everybody yeah. knows. But then still we find there is a lot of wastage happening.
Yeah.
So how do we stop this?
Mm-hmm.
So there is a session, we call it a plate of rice.
Oh, okay.
What do we do there? We actually ask them questions about what goes behind this plate of rice.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of starting a session with don't waste food. So we just say, what goes behind this plate of food or the plate of rice that
mm-hmm.
we eat every day?
Mm-hmm.
And we make it interactive.
Yeah.
By the end, and our questions are, you know, focused in bringing the answers in such a way from the students.
Mm-hmm.
The students, in the end of the session, themselves say that, no, we shouldn't be wasting food.
Yeah.
So that's when we then again, you know, make them think, okay,
mm-hmm.
is it only food, or should we apply this to all other things?
All other things, yeah.
So this is how the sessions, you know, are tailor-made to our,
yeah.
make our students learn more.
And that's it, that is more successful, I guess, because that
Absolutely.
Comes within, from the students. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing all the stories and journey with us today. And thank you so much for giving us your valuable time and sparing some time for us. Thank you so much for coming over.
And yes, I would like to add one thing.
Yes, ma'am.
This whole thing is so gratifying,
mm-hmm.
so fulfilling.
Yes, ma'am.
And, you know, I feel this is a privilege that
yes,
we are all enjoying as change makers.
Mm-hmm.
So any volunteer who comes here, that's what we keep telling them.
Yes, ma'am.
Be a part of this. Enjoy being, you know, part of the journey
mm-hmm.
of the students whom you're empowering.
Yes, ma'am.
You're being a part of their life
yeah.
to
True.
Empower them.
Yeah. True, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Sagarika.
Thank you so much for all this wise advice and the knowledge and the expertise that you shared with us today, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thank you so much, viewers, for staying connected and engaging with us.